Shalom and welcome to 2 Minutes of Torah. This year is entitled Parshat Aikev, the Neglected Mitzvot. Rashi quotes from the Medrash that Aikev Tishmon, if you follow even the mitzvot that are treated with the Aikev, with the heel that people step on, and you're serious about those mitzvot, then you're going to receive all the brachot in the Torah. What are these Aikev mitzvot, the mitzvot that are stepped upon? Is it an objective category? Is it subjective? What is it exactly? So some want to say, there is mitzvot kalot, there are mitzvot that are considered to be lighter. The punishment is lighter, and the Rambam in Hilchot Teshuva in the very first paragraph talks about different kinds of violations, one that are considered to be hamarot, more stringent, and one that are considered to be lighter. Rav Moshe Feinstein deals with it in his volumes of Drash Moshe, that it's not necessarily a mitzvah that a person doesn't keep. He says, Chas v'shalom, a Jew won't keep a mitzvah. It means, he doesn't treat it with such respect, but of course he keeps it. There's a lot of approaches. Some mention the possibility that maybe it's referring to mitzvot drabanan, the ones that are more like to protect the siyag, other mitzvot, and maybe some people don't take that so seriously. A lot of possibilities. Another possibility may be that it is totally subjective. And the fact is, there are mitzvot that are objectively of supreme importance, and truthfully, every mitzvah is of great importance. But this specific person, based on many reasons, his upbringing, his nature, his family, his personal leanings, he gets certain mitzvah just doesn't take seriously. So, for example, certain mitzvot, a person will go ahead, and in his culture, tzniut is nothing to talk about. So careful, and he's so careful about tzniut, she's so careful about tzniut. And then maybe other mitzvot that just aren't taken as seriously. And another person might be so careful about business ethics based on his personality, his family, his culture, his community. And he would never cheat anyone, a Jew or Gentile, from a penny, an agura. And yet, davening marv may not be something that he was exposed to in such a serious manner, and he never took it in a serious way. So that might be his Aikev mitzvah. Or a person grew up in a beautiful, firm environment, and for whatever reason, money was taken seriously, davening was taken seriously, learning was taken seriously, tzniut was taken seriously, and for some reason, this person, him, her, just had a very hard time with tzniut. It wasn't a background issue. It wasn't because it was pushed down her throat. Just for some reason, this is her challenge. We all have Aikev mitzvot and Aikev challenges. And Rashi is saying, if you work on your specific areas of challenge, then you're going to receive the greatest bracha. To go ahead and do the mitzvot that come naturally, that's fantastic. The ones that all the community is keeping and you just naturally go with the flow, Baruch Hashem, it's beautiful. But if you could go ahead and take those mitzvot that, for whatever reason, based on your nature, your nurture, your leanings, your own personal senses, that's what you find hard. And even though the community is not learning, or you don't have such a leaning towards learning, and you work on having a night seder every night you learn, even though it's so hard for you. Well, learning comes easy to you, but doing chesed, that's a challenge, and you work on that. Well, being a big tzaddik in the community comes easy for you, but at home, treat everyone with nice respect, that's the challenge. Whatever it is that is your Aikev, that's what has to be worked on. And you work on that, then you have great reward. Another person who's very serious about davening, and now he's in shul. So, Baruch Hashem, he davens very seriously. Another person, because of whatever Aikev reasons, he doesn't take davening so seriously. So now, he has an interesting interplay. He's this other one, the neighbor, is talking in the middle of davening because that's his Aikev mitzvah. So he, of course, has to try to work on this. Why is he talking in the middle of davening? And when he's not taking davening seriously, he's talking during davening, then it's a two-edged sword. It's between him and God and between him and man. Between him and God, he's not taking the mitzvah of davening seriously. And between him and a fellow man, he's disturbing other people davening. Other people cannot focus because of that. So there, he has to work. That's his Aikev mitzvah, her Aikev mitzvah, not taking davening seriously. And between him and God and him and fellow men, he has to do some work. And so too, the other person who takes davening very seriously. And now, anyone disturbs, he gets very upset, gets very angry. How can they not take this seriously? The most important mitzvah in the Torah, decorum, respect for the shul, respect for the davening, how could they? And that brings up all of his emotions. He might have a bit at work, he might have an Aikev mitzvah here. Davening is not his Aikev mitzvah. How to relate to others that don't take davening seriously, that might be his Aikev area. He goes and gives a dirty look, gives a stare, he screams at the person. The person has a baby in the shul. Baby's been quiet the whole time. Makes one little noise. All of a sudden, the mother, who's been davening first time, gets out in a few months, is davening so nicely, so happy she can be in shul davening. Oh, but the baby made a little peep. And now, in Magia, she deserves to go ahead and be stared down, get dirty looks, screamed at. So maybe that's that person's Aikev Mitzvah. So the very person who's so careful about davening, so Baruch Hashem, that's not his Aikev Mitzvah. But how to deal with others who are not so careful about davening, or who might make noise unintentionally, or if they make noise, so one has to deal with that properly. Maybe it's right to go over, you know, it's really disturbing. Or maybe assess that, you know, one little peep that's not really disturbing has to be assessed case by case. So we all have our Aikev areas that we step on for whatever reason, based on personality and background. And that's the challenge of this week's Parsha. Parshat Aikev, to go ahead and take every mitzvah and treat it with such seriousness and love and respect that it deserves, and whatever area it may be in, between us, man and man, between man and God, whatever it may be, whatever Aikev areas that we may have, and we all have our Aikev areas, to work on it and to go ahead and beautiful have a commitment to all areas of the Torah. And then when we have no Aikev mitzvot, and they're all taken seriously, we should all merit to have divine reward for all of them. Shabbat Shalom.